Well, it has certainly been feeling like summertime. We've been sitting in the upper 80s, near 90 degrees for many spots today. It has sparked a few isolated showers. I don't expect much out of this over the next several hours, but we'll see this same sort of theme as we get into tomorrow, as well as those temperatures will likely be even warmer. So waking up tomorrow morning, pretty much area wide, we are in the 60s. A few spots are going to be getting close to that 70 degree mark early tomorrow morning. We do have another day full of sunshine, but again, with the heat and the humidity, that could help to spark a few isolated pop-up showers by tomorrow afternoon into the evening. I expect most of us are dry, but can't rule out that brief spotty shower. Looking at tomorrow's high temperatures, 80s into the lower 90s, 92 degrees roughly here in the upstate. So it's going to be another hot day tomorrow. We do have some changes that are going to move in by Thursday, and that'll cool our temperatures down at least a little bit closer to where we should be this time of year. So mapping out Wednesday, mix of sun and clouds, should be another beautiful day, but notice a few of those isolated showers developing, especially as we get into late in the afternoon and into the evening. Most of us do remain dry at this point. Now, as we get into Thursday, that's where we start to see some changes. I think most of Thursday is fairly quiet. Once we get into the afternoon and evening, we could see a few showers out ahead of this front, but especially Thursday night into Friday, we're looking at some scattered showers. I think the bulk of the rain actually moves in during the overnight hours. So Friday is looking mostly quiet at this point. A few very isolated to widely scattered showers, and then the system is in and out of here, and this will also cool us down for the rest of the week. Now, all eyes have been on the tropics. We've been tracking this system that has had a pretty good chance of developing over the last few days, and those chances are ramping up. Now, a 30% chance of development over the next 2 days and a 70% over the next 5. And this is partially due to remnants of Agatha that worked over Mexico, and some of that moisture and activity is going to help to redevelop another system right around the Yucatan Peninsula. This area highlighted in red is that projection of where most of the models are at least initially expecting this system to go. So where it goes after that, where there's a little bit more inconsistency with the models. So let's look at our two main models that we watch when it comes to tropical systems. We've got the European and the GFS, which is our American model here. Both of which are picking up on a little bit of activity moving over Cuba and across the Florida Peninsula. GFS not holding very strong with this particular system. However, they both are indicating that there's some sort of activity that we need to watch. Once we get into next weekend, notice the European model really bringing this one closer towards the Carolina coast and the Georgia coast as we get into Sunday. GFS still bringing that system a little bit further out to sea. So lots to watch with this one over the next couple of days. I do expect us to see some sort of tropical activity over the next few days, but where it goes, still a little bit into question at this point, but we'll watch it for the next few days. But for the time being, mix of sun and clouds tomorrow. Isolated shower can't be ruled out. The 90s sticking with us through Thursday. Late day showers develop on Thursday, getting us into Friday, clearing us out and cooling us down just in time for the weekend. And then into next week, depending on that particular system that could bring some tropical activity, it could mean that we'll see some rain out of it into early next week. Still need to watch it, and we'll keep you updated over the next few days.